Ladies, thanks very much for joining us. Now, I'm sure a lot of you, like myself, every morning you look in the mirror and you see another little crease that doesn't go quite as quickly as it used to, maybe lime. You think, I wish I could do something about that. And you're bombarded with everything in magazines. Try this, try that. You never know how much of it's advertising, but you're desperate to try something. Well, we have a lady here today who is hopefully going to be able to point us all in the right direction. It is our skin guru, Joan from JL Formulations.
Hi. So I've got a question for you, girls and boy. And hands up how many of you would like to look 10 years younger? Nearly everyone. Oh, fab. I can tell you how. Please say hell yeah to this next question. And I'm looking at you especially. If I give you 3 simple steps to wiping years off, would you do it?
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Thank you.
At the back row, are we shouting hell yeah? Yeah, I can hear you good. Let's get serious for a moment. There'll be quite a few of you in the audience with skin concerns and feeling down and deflated about how to correct them. Am I right? No expensive creams and fancy bottles with lovely smells are going to do it. You've probably tried those already. Yep. Few hands up, few nods. This is what you need to know. So let's talk skin secrets. Firstly, what I'm all about is getting your future skin to look smoother, softer, less lines and wrinkles, which in turn is going to make you look younger, glowing and healthier. So future skin, think about it, future skin. So to understand how to look 10 years younger, I need to teach you some signs. So this is a little bit of a boring bit that I need to let you have a look at. Skin is made up of 3 layers, and you and I are going to work on the first 2 layers to become a younger version of ourselves. The outer layer, the one that you can touch, is called the epidermis. It's where the skin cells start at the bottom and work their way up to the top, eventually becoming flat, dead skin cells. And this is called the skin renewal system. Have you heard of that before? Yeah, skin renewal system. This process takes 28 days when you're in your 20s and up to 40 odd when you're in your 40s. I know it's awful, isn't it? The middle layer is called the dermis, and this is where the important collagen lies, the fiber. And for us girls, collagen helps us to stop us from becoming a saggy baggy lady. So collagen is very important to us, isn't it? We're all nodding, aren't we? We love collagen. Is this true? Is it true? If we take a collagen pill or apply a collagen cream, do you think it will help our collagen? If we take collagen pills and creams, is it going to help the collagen? Good. Good answer. No. Some people claim it's going to help make more collagen. I mean, we've all tried, we've all seen them collagen pills, take this collagen pill. Can I have a show of hands who really believes that taking a collagen pill internally is going to make more collagen? Show of hands. Do you believe that? You're so intelligent. I can look at these intelligent girls, ladies, and boy here. 2 boys, 1 man, 1. Anyway, that's really good. So don't believe this myth. It won't work to give you more collagen. Collagen is manufactured by these little guys behind me called fibroblasts. And we have to stimulate them. Stimulate them, which I'll go into later. The most important thing you can do is protect the collagen you have at present. Apart from the natural aging process, the 3 biggest enemies of collagen are the 3 S's. Sun. Okay? 80% of aging is caused by UV rays. I'm looking at all you girls with the tan just now, and I'm hoping it's fake. 80% of aging is caused by the sun. Is that not incredible? It is, isn't it? I see a lovely pill of porcelain skin there. Good on you, girl. So the next one is sugar, and I have to put in brackets here. Alcohol, glass of wine. Yeah, no wonder you're laughing, Jean. Sugar, the latest do not eat good stuff, attaches to collagen and makes the collagen protein stiff and not work. So you really have got to watch the sugar content, girls. So think glass of wine, glass of water. Glass of wine, glass of water. You're doing that already, aren't you? I can tell. And the final one is smoking. Yeah, Doc Cotton Face. Hope she's not here today. Hope you don't know Rachel. Anyway, Doc Cotton Face. It's thought now that the aging process accelerated 14 years if you smoke. Okay, are we going to get any people, is there any smokers left? We're too frightened to say, aren't we? No smoking. If you're in your 40s and smoke 30 cigarettes a day, your skin is going to look 54 years old. So the first secret to looking younger, the first secret is wear an SPF 30 every day for the rest of your life. Woohoo! Are you going to remember that? Wear an SPF 30. Is anybody wearing SPF 30 just now? 1, 2, anybody else? 3, 4, 5, 6. That's not bad. By the end of this, you better all be going, yeah, I'm going to wear it, I'm going to wear it. I'm going to listen for you to say it. So think of it this way. If I get you to wear an SPF 30, under your makeup every day, this is going to protect your skin from UV and environmental damage. Your future skin, remember, your future skin is going to be less lined and wrinkled. You won't have so many aging broken veins on your face. There won't be any pigmentation or age spots. So not only are we protecting the collagen and keeping the bounce in your skin, we're going to make you look younger as you age. We're going to make you look younger as you age. Does that make sense? Yes, yes, yes. So, when we're in our 20s, in fact, I'll come on to this a little bit, sorry. We'll go back to the skin renewal system. I'm going to tell you about this because this is quite important. Now, when we're in our 20s, right, the skin is so full of energy. Is there anybody in their 20s just now? Not all put up their hands, I don't believe you. Right, we're in our 20s, right, so skin is doing this. It's sprinting, you know. Under those glasses, your skin is really sprinting like mad, okay? So that means you can have Friday, Saturday and Sunday nights out on the town and wake up Monday still looking good. So the skin is a workshop of repairing, renewing and detoxing all together at a sprinting rate. When we're in our 30s, any 30-year-olds in the house? Good? Good? Anybody else? 30? Yeah. I'm glad you're keeping in there and hearing me. Our skin is starting to slow down a little. It's still doing a nice run. I can tell you're a runner. So it's running, it's still quite fast, and maybe we can have Friday and Saturday nights out of town and wake up on Sunday still looking quite young. When we're in our 40s, who am I kidding? Anyway, 40s. Anybody in the 40s admitting it? Loving it? So in our 40s, our skin is now jogging. And boy, are we still happy that we can still jog at 40? Would you agree? However, now Friday and Saturday nights are starting to show. And we wake up on Sunday now looking as if we've not had any sleep for 2 nights. Can't do 2 nights in a trot. And then we reach our 50s. Skin is slowly walking now. And we know that we can't do 2 late nights anymore, even if we want to. If we have a late night to bed, never mind 2, next morning we look as if we've got flu, puffy eyes, and all we can see is the deep lines and wrinkles, especially on the side that we sleep. A quick tip here. How not ever to get any wrinkles, right? Get a pillow, stick the pillow when you go to bed, and lie sleeping on your back. Have you tried that? Sleeping on your back won't give you any wrinkles and you'll always look fantastic. No, have you tried that? Well, it's blinking hard. I have tried it a lot of times. You end up still going back to the side. So, there's lots of YouTube videos about it actually. I'm a sad person that's looked up sleeping on your back in YouTube videos. I'm doing anything to hide a line, not to get them. So the skin renewal system is all about repairing, renewing and detoxing and slow down in our epidermis, which is quite thin in our 20s. Where's my 20-year-old? And now, it's slowed down in our 20s and now doubles in size, so our dead skin cells are adhering to our skin surface longer and not exfoliating, therefore causing lines and wrinkles to look much deeper, causing skin to look pigmented, causing skin to look thicker, older and sluggish. I feel like crying now. Another point to remember is when you exfoliate, sorry I've just missed one here, I'm looking for number 15, found it. The second secret to good skin, exfoliate several times a week. Is anybody exfoliating just now? Once a week? Good, excellent, excellent. Anyone else? Anybody frightened of exfoliating? No? One person? So exfoliate several times a week. This is going to take as many dead skin cells to thin the skin down to make it look smoother, less lined and wrinkled. Pigmented areas are going to look better and your skin is going to look brighter and younger, I promise. So that's the second secret, exfoliation. Another part to remember is exfoliate only at night before you go to bed. Just now we're going into autumn and winter, although today I believe it's lovely outside, right? Autumn and winter, it was freezing this morning and I was walking the dog. Don't exfoliate when you go out in the morning, it's going to make your skin more sensitive. Do it at night when you go to bed. Is that a good tip? Thank you for nodding, thank you. Next time go, hell yeah. Okay, I'm listening for you. So exfoliate after you cleanse your skin and apply your good moisturiser. Any good serums or creams that you absorb much better into skin after you've exfoliated it. So they work much better. So have I got you girls applying, and boys, applying SPS every day? Have I convinced you? Love it. Have I got you exfoliating regularly? I love it, great, brilliant. And now for the third secret and the last secret to good skin. Are you ready for it? Now this time, this is the last one, you really need to shout to me this time. Are you super excited about the final step? Me for a skin consultation. That's good, isn't it? Ask me for a skin consultation and I'm happy to do that. Email me and tell me your skincare concerns and I'll help you fix them. How's that for a good one? Over to you, Rachel.
Thanks very much, Joan. That was great. Good fun as well. Thank you very much. We've got a couple of questions that I know ladies have been asking at your stand. We've had quite a few people saying, what about leaving your makeup on when you're going to bed in the evening? How bad is that?
Oh, leaving your makeup on at night? I won't look to see who asked that question, but... leaving your makeup on at night, going to bed? Well, hell yeah. Is it sort of, you know, I'm thinking Bradley Cooper, your mind aside? You know, depending who your mind aside, wearing your makeup to bed is a good idea? Hell yeah, it is. But then you've got to get back up after an hour and get into that toilet, get into that bathroom, get into that ensuite and take that makeup off. You've got to make sure you take your makeup off before you go to sleep at night. You've got to stop that skin from clogging. The makeup is going to stop all the skin underneath from repairing and renewing itself. Seriously, girls, no matter how you feel, get up and get in and take that makeup off. It's so important. That's when the skin is doing its massive work at night. Between 1 and 4 in the morning, skin is really fixing itself out. It doesn't want to fight against gunge, honestly.
Right, second question. My therapist has advised me to have a chemical peel, but I just think I'm going to look like Samantha from Sex and the City, and that scares me. Do you recommend them?
Has everyone seen that episode? What was that like? It was brilliant, wasn't it? You know, chemical peels are really good for skin. You've heard it here, and if you haven't heard it before, they are really good for skin, chemical peels. The really trick is to get someone good at applying them, okay? Even if you've got a sensitive skin, it's really good to take advice, but chemical peels slough off that dead top layer even better in exfoliation. You can do a mild chemical peel, but really and truly, chemical peels are really the way to go to look younger. Yeah, don't doubt it, honestly. Just getting the right advice from the right beauty therapist, the right skin expert on the right peel. This one that she had, that was TV, you know. You don't end up looking like that. I'm sure you can find a really good spa or salon that does, or skin clinic that does great peels. Good to have an expert that's helping you. Has that made you feel any better about it? Go on, get someone who's giving you the right advice. Anybody else got a question?
What effects do drinking coffee have on your skin?
Sorry, I can't hear.
Drinking coffee, what effects do you have on your skin?
Excellent.
Coffee.
Coffee.
Does that have any effects on your
absolutely.
Skin?
Absolutely. Nutrition is probably number 4 in there. Coffee absolutely is dehydrating to skin. Very much so. What's my advice there? Organic coffee and drink a bottle of water after it. Definitely. You'll see that in a lot of restaurants now. They're providing coffee with some soda water at the same time, and that's for that reason, because they know coffee really is a strong toxin. I'm not saying to give up coffee, because everything in moderation. I still like coffee, but I drink lots of water, whatever it is. Yeah, so it's okay, but lots of water. Good question. Anyone else? You can come up and ask me personally anyway. My stand is over here, or you can come up any time. Thank you so much for listening.
Thanks very much, Joan. Joan from JL Formulations.